We have to give a context of the 7.5-year project that will change the lives of our people considerably, despite any impediment that may come, whether you will pose as cheerleaders or noisemakers. We as government are unstoppable, and we stand to be the champion of the poor. The Ekurhuleni municipality conceptualized the Newport integrated flagship development in 2003. In 2006, an extensive procurement process led to the award of the contract to what we know today as the Newport Development Company. After the completion of the bankability study, the formal Newport business plan was approved in 2008 by the EMM Council. A long legal compliance process followed, which was the obligation of the EMM, whilst the Newport Development Company continued with the technical preparations of the project. So after the conclusion of the compliance process by EMM, the EMM and Newport Development Company got into a service level agreement and revised addendum to the development agreement in February 2016. Whilst the LDC proceeded further with technical preparations, a formal revised business plan was approved by EMM in November 2016. So it required a decade to reach a point of readiness where this flagship project can be implemented in earnest. The vision really of this project is to change the landscape of Ekurhuleni, change the landscape of Boksburg. It will become a place where dreams of families are born, where families can prosper and grow within a safe, quality and empowering environment. We are creating an environment where people can work, stay and play. Newport will accommodate the total spectrum of housing needs from families within limited resources who will be integrated in this high quality suburb, to families with the ability to migrate into the bonded housing market. I think the executive mayor spoke substantially to this, that there has been substantial challenges of integrating communities. And as I've said, we are embarking on the process of integrating all our communities. The Newport is divided into two geographical nodes, into Newport North and Newport South. So it is geographically structured in that fashion. And in the Newport North, we have two suburbs called Newport Extension 19 and Park Dean Extension 7. In Newport Extension 19, as the executive mayor has said, that we'll be focusing on typologies that on three specific typologies. We will be building fully subsidized housing that will therefore speak to semi-detached housing units and fully subsidized rental units. The fully subsidized rental units will give a total yield of 617, whilst the semi-detached housing units should be giving us a total yield of 153. This, we are still at Reger Park Extension 19. All of the combined, together with the partially subsidized housing, the social housing unit, should give us 1,592. Park Dean Extension 7, we are going to be having fully subsidized housing, meaning the RTP giveaways. They should be giving a total yield of 1,593, while the partially subsidized houses will be giving us a total yield of 3,983. When we speak about partially subsidized housing, we're speaking about the FLISP market. There's that component that do not qualify for RTP housing, who further do not qualify for bonds. So we create what we know as FLISP, abbreviated as the financial linked or the finance linked individual subsidy program. So as they are located in the gap market and they can't qualify for RTPs and they equally cannot qualify for bonds, we give them opportunity and access to the subsidy program called FLIP. So those houses, the gap houses should be 292 and the social housing apartments will be 2,093. The collective number that these housing units should give us is a total yield of 6,345. When we go to the Leeuwpoort South, the Leeuwpoort South extensively is composed of Sanwar Park, extension 24 to 29. I think those who are familiar with Sanwar Park know that that green field, that piece of land, which is virgin land, which is located between Carnival City and Kleporki. That piece of land is referred to as our geographical node of the Leeuwpoort South in Sanwar Park 24 to 29. The fully subsidized housing will be 1,334, which is the semi-detached and detached houses. The fully subsidized rental units will be 1,009. Then we have the partially subsidized housing in Leeuwpoort South, that, and we speak to that FLIST element again, which will be 2,193, and the FLIST apartments will give us a total yield of 5,901. And then we go to the third component, which is the fully bonded housing, which will give us 1,404, and bonded sectional title apartments that will give us 3,087. The total yield in Leeuwpoort South is 15,731. It is important to note that South Africa, that the Southern Development delivers 5 primary schools, private and public, 2 secondary schools, 1 private college, 7 community facilities, a private clinic, a retirement village of 639 units with a hospital and free care center, and the full spectrum of commercial, retail and medical office, sports and recreation, and other developments. The total housing yield, just to give a brief developmental summary, is that in the Leeuwpoort North, we are looking at 6,345, and in the Leeuwpoort South, we are looking at 15,722, and as reflected by the executive mayor, it should be giving us a total yield of 22,073 housing units. I think I have impacted to say 5,506 units are fully subsidized. That constitutes about 24% of the total project. 12,076 units are FLISP or gap housing social units, and they constitute about 54% of the total project. 4,591 units are fully bonded, and they give a total yield of 20.3%. To give a brief implementation program,